Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a while since I have last uploaded, but uni has gotten really hectic. I know this is not an excuse, everyone says the same thing, but my exams are next week, so just trying to do really good in that because I am looking to transfer. But yeah, I will have videos up as much as I can. I know during the holidays, once my exams are all done, I'm just going to keep filming and filming and filming and have them all ready for you so that I can upload more regularly. But yeah, so this is a autumn or fall look. I know that people in like America and stuff might be a bit confused by this, but in Australia at the moment it is autumn. So this is just a really orangey, copper, golden look that you can easily achieve at home. And I hope you guys enjoy. Thanks guys. I'm gonna start off with a primer and I'm going to use MAC Prep and Prime. And I'm just gonna apply this to my face just as a cream. Can't stay in one place. I'm gonna be using my MAC Studio Fix Fluid. And I think it's in NW35. This is a little bit dark for me, especially in like autumn slash fall, whatever you want to call it. So I'm also going to use this Revlon Nearly Naked foundation in medium beige, 180 medium beige, just to lighten up the areas that will naturally hit the sun, where the sun will naturally hit my face. Okay, so as you can tell, it gives a nice kind of glow to the face. It's not too dark, not too bright, kind of really good color. Now I'm gonna go on with the eyes. I've already done my eyebrows because I just was not having a good eyebrow day, and I am just gonna do this as I feel and just go with the flow. So yeah, all right, so I'm gonna zoom you guys in so you can see my eyes better and then we will start with them. So yeah, so in order to make sure that my color stands out really well, I'm gonna use a really light color. So almost a whitey creamy color, and I'm gonna use this color right here. And so it's a little bit peachy creamy, like a kind of beigey creamy color. I'm just gonna dab that with my fingers. I'm gonna use the Rich Gems palette by Chi Chi, this one right here, which has the most amazing colors. I really love them. Chi Chi's palettes are amazing. I have two of them. I wish I had all of them, but I don't, because I need to get a job. What I'm going to use now is this brush from Nude by Nature, and it is the Deluxe Eyeshader Brush. I'm going to go in with this orangey colour right here. I'm just going to apply that all over my lid. Because of the white that we've just applied, we're going to need to go over it a couple of times for the color to actually show. Okay, so the color is actually really orangey in real life. It's really sparkly, like you can see now, but it's got more of an orange tinge to it. So it's a really cute color. Now what I'm going to do is get a transition color. So you can use any orangey, warm-toned brown shade for this part. I'm going to be using my domed eye brush from Nude by Nature. This color here. So it's brown, but it's a warm tone brown. So I'm just going to apply that just above my crease. Now to add some depth into your eyes, I'm going to go for some grey tones and I'm going to put them in the corner of the eye. I'm going to go for this darker coloured grey here. And I'm going to use my e.l.f. Professional Defining Eye Brush. I'm kind of making it into like a V shape. So to make that a little bit more darker and to really define the edge of the eye and make it look a bit more full, I'm going to use the Nudes Chi Chi palette, and I'm going to use this grey metal colour over here with that same defining brush. I'm going to apply that in the very corner. Just going to bring it into the crease and just slightly above it. Just to blend in with that transition colour a bit better. So when I do it, to get that kind of cat eye shape, I use this brush on this angle, place it here, and then place it, turn the angle around so it faces this way, and do the top V. And then just fill in the rest. Now I'm going to get my blending eye brush from e.l.f. and just blend the grey into the rest of the orange. Just for the finishing touches, I'm going to get the Nudes palette again and use that little darker colour right and only in the very, very corner. I'm not going to bring it in at all, but I'm going to use it on the blending brush I can blend it out with. And bring it into the crease a little. So it starts off a really light peachy colour and then gets into a silvery metally colour. So I'm going to go get the wipe and I'll show you how to wipe off the excess. You're going to get your wipe and you're going to use the very corner like this. And you're just going to go up here and lift that up. You can even go the other way, start downwards and bring it down. But just make sure you do it on that angle so you get that really clean clean cut. And if there's any down here, just tap that off. Okay, now, if yours turned out like mine, you should have this really pretty shimmery color down here from that orange. So I'm gonna leave that there. If you don't have that, I want you to take a small like angled brush. This one is by e.l.f. And once you get that same orangey color that we have used, grab a little bit of that and just carefully, because you don't want to poke out your eye, place it down on your waterline. Bring it into your crease as well. And then along the rest. And now we're gonna get the angled brush that you used in the corner, and whatever's left on it, just use that to bring in to the rest of the eye. Now try to focus this one more up the top. That way you have like your darker color and your orange kind of underneath it. And stop where your eyelashes end. I'm going to use my Maybelline New York Master Precise Liquid Liner, which is amazing. If you don't have it, get it. It's really easy to apply. And you can always start off really light and just build up your eyeliner. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Okay, so once your eyeliner is as perfect as you can get it, I'm going to go in with the mascara. I'll show you my favourite combination of mascara that I've been loving. So I'm just going to curl my eyelashes first. Okay, so for mascara, I like to use this Essence I Love Extreme Volume Mascara. It is so good for a cheap mascara. So I'm going to apply about 2 coats of this. Don't let it dry too much. Then do it like straight after you've done that one, otherwise it tends to get really clumpy and it ends up being hard to apply. I like to always use 2 mascaras because I love eyelashes and I want them to be as big as possible. So I'm going to apply my MAC mascara What the hell is the name of this mascara? I'm sorry guys, it had a name. Maybe on the box, but it's just, I don't know. I'm sorry. If I find out the name, I will leave it in the link, and it's, I think, in Extreme Black. And I'll just do one coat of this. So I personally need a lot of mascara when I have thick liner on because I just feel like you can't see my lashes and I need to see my lashes. So that is why I apply so much, in case you're wondering. Then I'm just gonna put some eyeliner on if I can find one. Here we go, I found it. So I'm using Essence Long Lasting Eye Pencil in 01 Black Fever. I'm going to apply it to the bottom, all the way up into the corner, along an eye stop about here. You can go further in if you want to, it's your choice. I'm also going to just bring it onto my lashes a little bit, just to make it a little bit more smoked out. Same thing on the other side. Now, if you want, you can put false lashes on. I'll quickly show you what it looks like with them. I'm not gonna apply them on camera. I will just put them on and be back, so give me a second. So these are the fake lashes. These are ones from MAC. I'm not sure what they're called. If I do find out, I'll list them in the Dropbox. Also, if anyone knows, anyone who lives in Melbourne or Australia knows where to buy Ardell Wispies from, please let me know, I would love them. Okay, I'm gonna quickly do bronzer and a bit of blush and then my lips and then we will be done. So I'm going to do that now. I'm going to use my e.l.f. Professional bronzing brush and my Astralis AC onto a contour kit. Use this brown orangey shade here. Apply it to the hollows of my cheek. Moving like the speed of sound. Make sure with this to always start light and just build it up. It is a really strong colour. Now I'm going to use my Savvy Mineral Baked Bronzer. So it's got those really nice shades in it. And my Revlon Kabuki brush. I'm just going to apply that to this part of my cheek. Just along my cheekbone. The speed of sound. I wouldn't recommend using a lot of this color because it's a bit full on. Then I'm gonna use my Nude by Nature. Oh, this thing is ridiculous. Hold on. Virgin blush. And use what's in the lid to not overdo it. And I'm gonna apply it to the apples of my cheek, like really lightly. Gonna use my Nude by Nature powder brush and this lighter color here from that one, just as a highlight. Now, lastly, is lips. I'm going to just do a bit of everything. I don't know. I'm gonna apply, my hair is ridiculous. Okay, I'm gonna use a lip liner. This is in Crushed Rose and it's an Avon one, but you can use any that you like. It's color like that. And I'm just gonna apply it to the outer parts. Then I'm going to use my Revlon 356 Soft Suede in the corners. I'm I'm just making this up as it goes, so I'm not really sure how it's gonna turn out. Blend that out a little. And then I'm going to use my Napoleon Perdis Disco Queen lip gloss. It's a bit of an orangey color. And I'm just gonna apply that to my lips. And there we go, guys, this is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed this and learnt how to, I don't know, do something from the video. At least if you learned one thing, that will make me happy. Hope you guys enjoyed. Let me guys know if you do try this out. If you do, please tag me on Instagram at janice.al. I'd love to see you guys recreating this look. Let me know what you guys think, and don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Yeah. Thanks guys for watching. Bye.